Let's revolutionize the way we filter data as well as pivot table. Let's start with data. Usually, what will you do? It's a table, you're going to use auto filter. Of course, we can use auto filter, but the problem is once you finish the filtering process, it closes and now you don't know what is the exact filter. If there are more than one filters, then again, it is difficult to visualize exactly what is being filtered. So let's solve this problem immediately. One of the buttons you always need is clear filter. It doesn't have a shortcut. So what should you do? Right click and add to quick access toolbar. I have already added it to quick access toolbar. Then where does it go? It goes here. And the best part is it'll get a shortcut as well. If you press and release the Alt key, Alt 1 is now clear filter. Watch, Alt 1, gone. Now let's look at slices. Click inside the data. It has to be a table. Go to the table menu and you will see insert slicer. When you click there, it's going to show you all the columns. You can choose one or more columns. Right now, I'm just going to choose one, which is month. Creates a separate window which floats around like this. I don't want a scroll bar, so I have two options. I can extend it so that the scroll bar goes away, or better still, when you click on a slicer, you will see slicer menu. Many options there, but the one we want right now is columns. So right now it's occupying so much space and this space is wasted on the right side. But if I increase the columns to 2 or even better 3 in this case, it's fitting nicely. So occupy minimum amount of space for the slicer without scroll bars. That's the best practice. Now let's see how it filters. It's very simple. Just click on it to filter. Exactly the same way as we used to do earlier, but now you can visually see what is the filter. How do you multi-select? Simple, control click. And even then you are seeing exactly what the filter is. Of course, whatever you filter here is going to reflect in the traditional auto filter as well. Now let's add one more filter. I'm going to clear this filter, click inside, go to table design, insert slicer. Another one I'll add as year. Years are not many, but I will still put two columns. Now let's see what happens. Slicer menu has many other options. It's a good idea to have different visual formatting for each type of filter so that it's clearer when you're looking at it. Now, the important part to understand is, of course, when I click on any of them, that's going to get filtered. Nothing great there. You already expect it. But what else happened? Look at that. When I clicked on 2018, it filtered the data. Yes, but it also filtered the other filter. So what do you see here? Only May and August we have data for. Others, we don't have data at all. And because the others don't have data, they're looking grayed out. And the ones which have data come on the top. Now, sometimes people get confused with it. Let me show you. I'm going to remove this filter. Now, Jan, Feb, March is the order. Now, if I click on one of them, Jan suddenly moved its position. And that may be very confusing. So how do you solve that problem? So click on the filter. Click on the slicer. Go to the slicer menu. And we have slicer settings. And one of the settings there is show items with no data last. And that's what is happening right now. But it is confusing to us, so I'll just remove that. And now what happens? Yes, it will of course show that May and August have data, but they are not changing their position. So it's much easier to interpret. So that's how slicers interact with data and with each other. Now let's go to pivot tables. Here I have multiple pivot tables based on the same data. Now what do we need to do? Generally what we have is pivot tables themselves have filter area. So I've already put month and year here. And the same problems occur here as well. If it is 1 month I'm filtering, then I will see which month it is. But it is more than one multi-select, then the same problem as before. It will show that it is multiple, but which items, obviously you cannot see unless you open it. That's extra effort. Now I've already added slicers here and you can see the impact, but let's do it from scratch. How do you add slicers here? Well, same process, click inside the pivot table. Go to pivot table, analyze tab, and there you will see insert slicer. Same story. This time I'm going to choose month and year together and we will do the formatting like before. I'm not going to explain it. Just two columns here and three columns here. Now, notice what is happening here. When I'm filtering on month, because that pivot table was already filtered on those 2 months, that is already reflecting here. Let's also understand something else. Because we added year filter, it understood that in 2014, we don't have data for this. So that is also filtered. That you would not have been able to see here. The only way for you to know in a traditional pivot table that August, November 2014 doesn't have data is to actually go to the year, select 2014, click OK, and then you will see an empty pivot table. That's an indirect and irritating, inefficient way of finding it. Here, you can see it clearly, visually, and interactively. That's the whole purpose of slices. Right now, everything seems to be working OK, but with one important limitation. Look at what is getting filtered. It's only that pivot table. Other pivot tables are not getting filtered. So how do you make this slicer work across pivot tables? That's the question. To answer that question, we have to create pivot tables in a particular way. So of course, you have data. You go and insert a pivot table. Fine. But when the first pivot table is created, immediately copy it, as many copies as you need, and then you change the structure of each pivot table. So essentially, these are copies of each other. Basically, behind the scenes, they are using the same data cache. And that's important. If you go three times to the data and create three different pivot tables, the same slicer cannot handle them. So they have to be copies. But even then, the filter is not being applied to other two pivot tables and chart. Why is that? Because we have not told the slicer to control other pivot tables. So let's do that. Click on the slicer. Go to the slicer tab and you will see a button called report connections. This button was there when we had filter in tables as well. The issue is table is not a pivot table, so that button is inactive. When it is a pivot table slicer, that button will be active. So let's go to that button, and predictably enough, it's going to show you all the pivot tables which depend on the same data cache. Normally, you will see pivot table names as pivot table 1, 2, 3, but I have taken that extra step. Go to a pivot table analyze, click on pivot table name, and there you can change the generic name to a more relevant name. Now, let's go to the slicer finally and connect it to other pivot tables. Of course, right now I am connecting the month slicer. You will have to repeat this process for the other slicer as well. And now, as expected, you will see filtering happening across all pivot tables. I'll zoom out so that you can appreciate what is happening right now. So this is how everything works as expected. Single filter controlling multiple pivot tables. Now the best part is that slicer need not be on the same page as the pivot table. You can spread out those pivot tables on multiple sheets. In fact, you can actually create a sheet which contains only slicers like this. And you decide what do you want. And then in the next sheet, it will already have filtered those pivot tables. So this gives you an option of creating a sort of a filter menu on a separate sheet, and that controls the rest of the workbook. In this pivot table, we have data up to 2020. Now I'm just going to add one record manually for 2023. When you come back to the filter, it's not going to show it. But because everything is based on the same data, when you refresh, either the pivot table or even the slicer has a refresh option when you right click on it, it's going to behave exactly the same way. Now, there is one more thing you should know. Sometimes data doesn't get added, it gets deleted. So again, I'm going to bring this back to 2020. And now when I refresh, notice what happens. I can refresh pivot table or slicer, doesn't really matter. Now it is shown as grayed out. Now this may indicate that there is data for 2023, but in the current filter context, it is not there. That is a potential confusion. So it's a very good idea to avoid this problem by going to slicer settings and show items deleted from data source, which is what we just did. We should not show that because that's going to be a very confusing thing. And now it is working exactly the way you want. Then you of course have other options like what kind of sorting you want, ascending, descending, or custom list. There is another special type of slicer that is for dates. So here is another pivot table. Pivot table analysis, right next to slicer, we have insert timeline. It only shows you one field right now because I only have one field of type date. This one occupies a lot of space horizontally and vertically as well. So you need to rearrange it. Because we are learning, I'm going to give it a little more space. Now, it has months, years, quarters, days, four levels. Now let's go to years. Now it's showing me the entire range of years available. I can click on any year to filter it. And these handles I can drag to change the range. I can change the range from either side, but I cannot move it. I have to drag from either side. But suppose I go to months, now it is showing me year and months. So I can either decide the range from here, and if it is going beyond the available area, I can also horizontally scroll. The only disadvantage I find is it occupies too much space. But if it adds value from a business analytics point of view, by all means, go and use this feature, insert timeline. And that is how you use slicers to filter data visually and interactively in raw data as well as pivot tables in Excel. I'm sure you found this useful. You know what to do. First thing you should do is share it with as many people as you can. Second, if you have any questions, if I missed something, feel free to post it in comments. I'll be happy to address them. And of course, like, subscribe, click on the bell icon. And there is an additional thing to do. There is a thanks button as well provided by YouTube. Explore that. And before you go, I recently created another comprehensive video on a very ancient but very powerful feature called GoTo Special. I'm sure you will love it. Have a look at it. So that's it for now. Thank you.